guys, me, David Arcarca Films here. Welcome back to an episode of Madden 17 New York Giants franchise. In this episode, it is week number 3 as the New York Giants go to Philadelphia to take on the Eagles. And yeah, this is a classic rivalry matchup, divisional matchup. And as you can see, the Giants are 1-1 and the Eagles are 0-2 under head coach Matt Hedrick, no longer Doug Peterson. So it's going to be McAdoo versus Hedrick, and it is a rainy day here in Philadelphia. Hopefully that's a bad sign for them and a good sign for us. But this team is 4th in total offense, so they must be doing something right on offense, and that we've got to be able to stop it. Of course, we had the number 1 defense last year, and I think we do right now, so hopefully we can continue that. And this team really hasn't changed much over the past couple years at all. It's still the same core guys on their team. And the key matchup today is going to be Eli Manning versus Malcolm Jenkins and Rodney McLeod, two great safeties that the Eagles have, and hopefully Manning does not throw any interceptions. It's going to be tough to go deep with both of them back there, but we'll hope to find a way to find Odell Beckham Jr. as this game is underway here in a rainy Philadelphia. Theo Riddick back to return, and he's going to take this one out to about the 21-yard line, and out comes Carson Wentz. This is now his third year in the NFL. He has 4 touchdowns, 5 picks, 630 yards, and a 58 completion percentage. A pretty rough start for him so far. On 1st and 10, he's going to find Nelson Aguilar. Aguilar with speed! He found the mismatch against the linebacker, and Aguilar is going to go all the way for a touchdown. Very first play of the game is 79 yards for an Eagles touchdown, and the extra point is going to make this 7-0 Eagles in just one play. We've got to be able to do better than that. It really wasn't Shaq Thompson's fault. The play call, I guess, from the Giants was not that great. But anyway, Adam Humphrey's back to turn, and he's not quite going to get to the 20. Actually, he is. Eli Manning now is going to come out. 8 touchdowns, 3 picks, 800 yards, and 74 completion percentage. He's had a pretty fast start, and hopefully he can continue his recent success over the past couple years. Here's Paul Perkins around the outside, and he's going to be brought down after a short gain. Right here you can see Eric Flowers and Brandon Cota. Both guys have been struggling as of late. Everyone else has been pretty solid. And Lance Dunbar, I'd like to get more involved in these games because, of course, he's replacing Shane Vereen, who led the team in receptions last year. So hopefully he can get going at some point. And Will Tye is going to make the catch for the first down. And it looks like an Eagle is down with an injury. I'm not quite sure who that is, which means he's really not that important. I'm sorry. But, yeah, he's just some rookie or something. I don't know. I've never heard of him. There's a carry by Perkins. He's going to take it for a couple. And as you can see, they lost a lot of their defensive line. Fletcher Cox is gone. A lot of their major defensive linemen are gone. They have Jordan Hicks, Michael Kendricks, two athletic linebackers, along with Malcolm Jenkins and Rodney McLeod back there. But they don't have that great of corners, so Manning's going to look to take advantage of that. Right here on 2nd and 5, Paul Perkins is going to fall forward, picking up the first down. 1st and 10, another handoff to Paul Perkins right down the middle. The Giants are taking advantage of the lack of defensive talent on the defensive line of the Eagles. 2nd and 3, out pass right there to Lance Dunbar. He's going to get the ball down to the 36-yard line. 1st and 10, handoff off to Perkins again. He gets 9 on that play. 2nd and 1, another handoff to Paul Perkins as he dashes his way down to the 16. 1st and 10, another handoff to him. This time he's going to be stopped for no gain. 2nd and 10 right here, screen to Perkins. Perkins with speed is going to pick up some yards. That is going to be 6 yards rather. 3rd and 4 underneath the Nolan Meyer on the drag, and he's going to be stopped shy of the first down marker, so the Giants are going to settle for a field goal. That was a nice drive right there, and unfortunate that they could not cap it off with a touchdown, but a field goal is still good, as a touchdown puts the Giants ahead by 3, of course, now, so hopefully they can get a turnover here or something, get the ball back. Here's Theo Riddick returning this one out to the 27. 1st and 10, a pitch to Riddick now. He's going to try to hit the outside, but that's Quan Alexander there to make the tackle. And now let's take a look at the Eagles' offense. They lost a lot of their talent on their offensive line, too. I only see Lane Johnson there, who's pretty good. And not that great of talent there as the skill player. So hopefully the Giants can take advantage of this lack of talent on this team today, as Beckham is going to make the catch for the first down. Theo Riddick going nowhere on first down. 2nd and 14, out past the Zach Ertz. Trucks through one man and is finally brought down by Bennett Jackson. 3rd and 8 from the 41-yard line. Wentz is going to fire this to the sideline, and it is going to be caught for a first down. Great catch right there by the receiver. 1st and 10, handoff to Riddick right up the middle, and he's going to get a couple on the play. And let's take a look at the Giants' defense. Dominant defensive line right there. Hopefully they can take advantage of the lack of talent on the offensive line for the Eagles. And our front seven is just pretty much just dominating. Hopefully. The guys that need to step up, I think, are our secondary. Our free safety position is a little bit open at the moment. No person is really stepping up to do anything. It's right there. Jason Pierre-Paul makes a big tackle for a loss. Third and 11 here from the 43-yard line. Wentz looking deep. He floats it to Dorial Green. Beckham, who makes the catch over Jackrabbit Jenkins and is forced out of bounds by Darian Thompson. First and goal from the two. Wentz drops back, fires underneath, and it's going to be caught for a touchdown by Jordan Matthews. And that's going to put the Eagles up 14-3 here after the extra point, which is coming up. Robert Griffin, the third on the hold, I just saw. What the heck? How is he on the Eagles? And they're going to kick that one through the uprights to make it a 14-3 game. Here's Adam Humphries back to return. He's going to take this one out to about the 30-yard line, and there is going to be a flag on the play. I think they're going to add 15 to that as there is a face mask on the tackle on Gruger Hill. And that is going to be accepted by the Giants. So the ball comes out to the 44-yard line. First and 10, Manning is going to float that one out of bounds in the direction of Will Tye. Second and 10, play action fake. Manning looking deep, rolling out to his left, trying to buy time. He's going to fire across the field. He has a man wide open, and he overthrows him. Nolan Meyer right down the middle of the field was wide open, and he just missed him. Third and 10, the play action fake buys time, and that allows the pass rush to get there. So Manning is hit as he throws, and the ball falls incomplete. And on fourth and 10, that's going to be a great punt right there by Brad Wing to pin them at the 8-yard line. Wentz now fires across the middle of the field. It's caught by Wooten. At right across the middle for a first down. First and 10, play action fake. Wentz is going to lob this one deep under immediate pressure. He had no choice but to get rid of it. Second and 10, Wentz again feeling the pressure. He's going to fumble the football. It's recovered by an Eagles offensive lineman, and Shaq Thompson is going to make the tackle at the 6-yard line. Third and 26 from the 6-yard line. Olivier Vernon, Jason Pierre Paul, get the safety on Wentz. Wentz backed up into the end zone, and both ends made the play, and that is going to be a safety. So the Giants now are down 9 points. So that's 3 field goals or a touchdown, and a field goal puts them up by 1. So this is very good defensive play right there by the Giants. First and 10 after the punt. This is going to be Brashad Perryman picking up the first down on the drag. First and 10 once more from the 48 now. Manning's going to find Sterling Shepard on the drag, and that's going to go for about 4. Second and 6. Out pass to Perkins, who's unable to hang on. This sets up a 3rd and 6 from the 48. Manning again looking short. It's going to fire to Nolan Meyer, and he had no chance of catching it as there was an eagle breathing down his throat. I don't know what I just said, breathing down his neck. What did I just say? Fourth and 6, another great punt right there by Brad Wing. First and 10, that's going to be another safety. Quan Alexander and Deshaun Benford there to get the safety again. Back-to-back safeties on Eagles drives. That might be an NFL record. I'm not sure if that's ever happened before, but the Giants defense is just putting up numbers right now as Borio is going to return that one out to the 29. Manning trying now. A touchdown is going to tie this game. Perkins accelerates forward with a lot of effort to only get 3 yards. Second and 7, a wild pass by Manning overthrows Nolan Meyer. Third and 7 from the 32. Manning has a lot of time. He's going to find Adam Humphries, who takes a big shot from McLeod. It's going to be short, but 4th and 1. McAdoo's going to go for it. Underneath pass to Perryman, and Perryman will pick up the first down. First and 10. It's going to be Perkins again up the middle. He's going to get no gain on the play. Second and 10, out pass to Nolan Meyer, who has a lot of space. Turns this one upfield, and that's about a 25-yard gain right there. First and 10 now from the 36 in Eagles territory. This is going to be Earl with the catch. Earl's going to muscle his way past McLeod and out of bounds for the first down. First and 10 across the middle to Adam Humphries now. He's going to get about 8 or 9 on the play. Second and 1 on the 15. This is going to be Perkins powering forward, picking up the first down. First and 10 again, just gashing up the middle is Paul Perkins. Second and 5. This is going to be Manning on the pass. He's going to go out the back of the end zone. No one was open. Third and 5 now from the 8-yard line. Right over the middle to Odell Beckham Jr. and Manning with a big time touchdown pass as he's going to put the Giants now tied with the Eagles after this extra point by Prater, and that is going to be good. And speaking of Prater, he's going to boot this one deep, and it is going to be deep in the end zone, and Aguilar is going to catch it out of bounds. So it brings Eagles out to the 25. First and 10, handoff to Riddick. He's going nowhere, stonewalled by Olivier Vernon. Second and 12, Wentz in the pocket. A lot of time, throws it deep down the field, and Shaq Thompson there on the coverage on Zach Ertz, denies Ertz of the football. Third and 12, Theo Riddick going nowhere. And on fourth and 12, they have to settle for a punt. The Giants have 2 timeouts and a minute 45 to work with, so let's see what Manning can do here after this return by Humphries. He's going to bring it out to the 37. First and 10 from the 37-yard line out to Adam Humphries, who's going to pick up the first down and a little bit more. First and 10, play action, faked up Beckham. Manning throws it over to Perkins. Perkins with speed, but he's chased down by Kendricks, who made a touchdown-saving tackle right there. Second and inches right over the middle of the field to Perkins. He's going to be absolutely annihilated, cannot hold on to the ball. third and inches. Manning under pressure is going to roll right into the coverage. No, it's not. It's going to be batted down. Manning could not find anyone. Fourth and inches. McAdoo going for it again. Very aggressive right here over the middle, and it's going to be incomplete. And Manning is having a tough time in this game. First and 10. That ball is going to be on the ground as Wentz dropped it by the hit by Jason Pierre-Paul, but it's recovered by the Eagles. Second and 23. Out pass to Aguilar, and he is going to make the catch. No, he's not. You can see right here that his left foot is just out of bounds. His toe right there is out. So it's going to be third and 23. Hand off to Riddick. He's going to be stopped by Damon Harrison. God dang it. I still call him Damon. What the heck? Someone said I sound like a Jamaican when I say that, and that's sort of funny. I'm just going to call him Snacks because that is what he is. Anyway, first and 10 right here. Hand off to Paul Perkins to the outside. He's going to be stopped shy of the 40-yard line. So the game will be tied going into the half, as the Giants have 14, and so do the Eagles. Manning was played a little bit sloppy, and hopefully he can rebound here as he gets the ball to start off the second half. This is Adam Humphries back to return from inside his own 10-yard line, and he's going to take this one out to about the 25. First and 10 from the 25-yard line. Another fake here. Manning looking for that same play. Wild throw, almost intercepted. Manning has been struggling with the ball. It might be because of the rain. And speaking of handling the ball, he's going to drop it right there, but it's recovered by Eric Flowers. Third and 15, he's going to get sacked again. A lot of pressure. That time it's Rodney McLeod getting the better of Eli Manning on the sack. And on fourth and 25, after a terrible drive right there, the Giants are going to have to punt the ball back to Riddick. And he has great field position here as he's going to bring it out to the 46-yard line. Out comes Carson Wentz. Hand off to Theo Riddick. He's going to take this one for a couple. Second and 9 right here. Another handoff to Theo Riddick right up the middle. That's going to be tackled by Darquez Denard. Third and 5 from the 48-yard line. Wentz fires it over to Doriel Green-Beckham, who breaks a tackle and is down at the 30, down into Giants territory. First and 10, another handoff to Riddick. He's going to be stopped by Snacks. Second and 10 right here from the 30-yard line. Wentz under a bit of pressure. He's going to fire to Aguilar, and Aguilar is going to pick up a solid chunk of yardage. Third and 6 right here from the 26-yard line. Wentz under pressure again from Olivier Vernon. He's going to dump it underneath to Theo Riddick, and that's going to be shy of the first down marker. So they're going to settle for a field goal, and they're going to put the Eagles up 17-3. Great kick right there. So the Eagles are up by 3, and Manning needs to respond and not fumble the freaking football. Holy crap. Here comes Adam Humphries back to return once more. I feel like I've said that 100 times. He's going to bring it out to the 21. First and 10 now from the 21. This is going to be Eli Manning on the slant to Brashad Perryman, who tries to break away from Malcolm Jenkins, but Jenkins is there to make the solid tackle. Second and 3, Beckham in motion. Manning under pressure, and he's sacked. That's going to be more on the sack. That's his second sack of the day. Third and 8 underneath pass to Perryman, and he's going to be blown up by Michael Kendricks. So once more, the Giants are going to have to punt. Not great catching here by the Giants receivers. A lot of drop balls, a lot of mishandlings by the Giants. Maybe because of the rain, I don't know. First and 10 underneath that Nelson Aguilar. He takes a shot from Quan Alexander for a gain of 5. Second and 5 right over the middle to Zach Ertz. They're going to give him the first down. First and 10 now from the 33. There's going to be a false start on the Eagles. So that's going to back them up 5 to the 28-yard line. It's going to be on Sumalo. First and 15. Quick slant to Matthews. He's going to pick up a lot of the yardage back. Second and 4 here from the 39. Wentz quick pass to Zach Ertz. Zach Ertz with speed. Darian Thompson gave him a lot of room right there. And he's going to be chased down by Landon Collins. Darian Thompson is getting burnt right now. First and 10. It's going to be a handoff to Theo Riddick right up the middle for a gain of 3. Second and 7. Another handoff that time. Quan Alexander having none of it. Third and 10 from the 11-yard line. This is going to be Wentz under pressure, flushed out, and he's going to be sacked by Olivier Vernon and Jason Pierre-Paul once more. So on 4th and 18, they're going to settle for yet another field goal. Now a touchdown and an extra point will put the Giants up by 1 with the entire 4th quarter left. Eli Manning has got to do something here as Humphries is going to kneel this one in the end zone, which brings the ball out to the 25-yard line. 1st and 10 from the 25. Manning is going to be hit. He puts the ball on the ground. Brandon Cota, the guy who let the guy through to make the fumble, is going to pick it up and run it back for a couple more yards. Second and 16 right here. Michael Kendrickson on the sack. Third and 23 from the 12. More pressure. He's going to fumble the ball again. And once more, it's recovered by the Giants. That is going to be Manning's like fourth fumble of the game. He's got to hold on to the football. And our line has got to block against this terrible Eagles defensive line. On fourth and 26, that's going to be a punt out to midfield. So it's going to be great starting field position for the Eagles on the screen. That's great tackling there by Denard. Second and fifth, or five rather, that's going to be Shaq Thompson right up the middle. He gets his second sack of the day. Third and 15, that's going to be a pass along the sidelines but he is going to be shy of the first down marker by an entire 8 yards. So on 4th and 8, they're going to punt this one away, and they're going to try to pin us at the 15. 1st and 10. Manning's going to throw a pass out to Perryman, who makes a great grab backing up towards the sideline. 1st and 10 from the 32. Now that pass over the middle is almost intercepted. Manning forced that one. 2nd and 10 right here. Out past the Nolan Meyer, who tries to fall forward for the first down, but he's denied by Michael Kendricks. 3rd and 1, pass over the middle of the field. Nolan Meyer again. He's going to take this down into Eagles territory, and the Giants are now driving. 1st and 10, play action fake. Manning's pass is going to be batted down at the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10, Manning looking deep right between the safety and the corner to Beckham, and Beckham takes a hard shot right there by Rodney McLeod. 3rd and 10 with 5 minutes left to go in the game. Manning is going to get sacked, but there is a flag on the play. It's going to be a face mask on the Eagles, and that is going to set the Giants up with a plus 15 yards and a new first down. 1st and 10. This is going to be Manning sacked again by Colbert. 2nd and 16. Manning going deep to Perryman, who makes the catch in the end zone for the touchdown. Big time play right there by Brashad Perryman to burn his man. And Manning found him after a rough game of accuracy problems for Manning. He's able to throw that deep pass and put the Giants up by one right there. Prater's going to boot this one deep to Riddick, who's going to catch it on his own 4-yard line. He's going to take this one out to about the 26 or 7, 27. 1st and 10. Wentz in the pocket. It's going to be sacked right there by Olivier Vernon. 2.5 sacks on the day for him. He's having a big game. 2nd and 17. Down the middle of the field. It's going to be caught by Matthews right in front of Darian Thompson, who for some reason did not step up to make the play. Now Doriel Green Beckham with a big catch on the post route. 1st and 10 now from the 34. Wentz going down the field quickly, but this time he has to throw it away. 2nd and 10, 2 minutes left in the game. That's Beckham with the catch, and he's going to be short of the first down marker. 3rd and 3, this pass right over the middle of the field to Wooten, and he's going to be dragged down by Darian Thompson right between the zones. 1st and goal from the 7. Wentz is going to roll out to his left. He's going to fire it on the run to Aguilar, and he's going to be stopped by Shaq Thompson at the 3. 2nd and goal right here. Wentz fires it to the back of the end zone, and it's caught by Doriel Green Beckham, who beats, Jackrabbit Jenkins on the coverage. 2-point conversion right here. Wentz, quick slant to his receiver, but it's going to be batted down by Darian Thompson, and that is going to set up Eli Manning down by 5 with a minute 27 left. All 3 timeouts. Eli Manning's got to have something happen here. 1st and 10 from the 25-yard line. Manning is going to be sacked right up the middle. Justin Pugh could not block his man. 2nd and 17 right here. Manning, all the time in the world, throws this one deep to Humphreys. Humphreys with the catch and out of bounds at the 50-yard line with a minute left to go in the game. 1st and 10 over the middle of the field to Paul Perkins, who finally makes a catch. He's going to be shy of the first down marker by about a yard. 2nd and 1. Deep pass right here to Beckham, and he burns his man. Touchdown, Giants. Oh, my gosh. Manning could have not thrown that better. He put it right where it had to be. 2-point conversion on the way. Quick slant to Beckham, and that is going to put the Giants up by 3. So now only a touchdown can beat them. A field goal ties them. And, this is looking pretty good for the Giants right here. 49 seconds left. The Eagles have all 3 timeouts. Here comes Theo Riddick down to the 28-yard line. 1st and 10 here. Wentz in the pocket. He is a lot of time. He's going to throw this one deep to Matthews, who makes the catch at the 46. Darian Thompson, I don't know what he is doing this game, but he is not doing good. 1st and 10, right in front of Landon Collins that time, is the catch by Zach Ertz, and they're driving fast. Now on the 15, 20 seconds left, underneath pass to Theo Riddick, makes a man miss, but there's a flag on the play. It's going to be coming back. It's going to be holding on the Eagles. On Eduardo Bowens, the left tackle. So 1st and 20. They're going to hand the football off with 15 seconds. What are they thinking? 2nd and 23. Another handoff to Theo Riddick. I guess they're just trying to burn out the clock. And on 3rd and 18 right here, another handoff to Theo Riddick. 7 seconds left to go in the game. 4th and 15. They're going to kick it, and it's going to be good. There's a flag on the play, and it is going to be a what? It is going to be against Landon Collins on roughing the kicker. They're going to decline it and accept the field goal. So with 4 seconds left to go in the game, it is tied at 29, just like how the first half ended, tied at 14. Now it's tied at 29, and the Giants are looking to do something here. Nope, they're just going to hand the ball off to Paul Perkins, who's going to be brought down by Michael Kendricks from behind, and that is going to set up the overtime period. So we're going to do the coin toss and everything. But this game has been very, very exciting here as it is tied at 29. Beckham with a few nice catches there at the end of the game. Nice ball placement by Eli Manning has progressively gotten better throughout the game. He started off a little shaky, but hopefully he can continue this into overtime if we do get a chance to get the ball, because the Eagles, if they score a touchdown, this game is over. And right here, the coin toss. The Giants win it, which means they're going to elect to receive. And now a touchdown for the Giants means that the Eagles don't get the ball back, and the Giants are going to win the game if that happens. If they score a touchdown, I mean. And right here, this kick is going to be back for Adam Humphries from inside his own 10. He's going to bring this one out to the 25-yard line as this is first and 10 now. Manning is going to throw an out pass here to Paul Perkins. Makes the catch with speed. That's a gain of 20 on the play. Great play right there by Paul Perkins. First and 10. Deep pass to Beckham. He just overthrew him. He was wide open and Manning overthrew him. Oh my gosh. Second and 10. Manning's going to run backwards and is brought down by Brandon Graham. Third and 19. Hit as he throws by Malcolm Jenkins. And the Giants have to punt the ball away. What the heck is going on? And that kick is down at the 6-yard line. Oh my gosh, what a pump by Brad Wing right there. First and 10, handoff to Theo Riddick. He's going to be stopped for a little to no gain. Second and 9 from the 7 right here. Wentz in the end zone. He's got to be careful. He's going to throw that one out of bounds. That was almost a safety if he would have thrown that out of bounds when he was in the end zone. Third and 9 from the 7 here. He's trying to make something happen. Wentz under pressure. He's going to be sacked. A safety's going to end an overtime game. Oh my God. Olivier Vernon off the edge. 3.5 sacks on the day for Olivier Vernon. Makes the tackle in the end zone. That's his second safety of the day. Olivier Vernon gets the game MVP for sure. Wentz, that's his third safety of the game. That has to be an NFL record. There's no way another team has gotten three safeties in one game. That's called defense right there. I think our defense scored just as many points as our offense. No, I know they didn't, but let's just say that they did. Oh my gosh, what a game by the Giants defense, although they let the Eagles go right down the field. Darian Thompson had a very rough game, but let's take a look at it right here. Eli Manning, 23 for 40, 319 yards and 3 touchdowns. Paul Perkins, 13 carries, 55 yards. And Rashad Perryman with 5 receptions, 75 yards, and a touchdown. Perryman was extremely, extremely good as the Giants go to 2-1. The Eagles go to 0-3. That's going to be the end of this episode, guys. Comment, subscribe, your veggies. Go to school. Dan Carr, thumbs out. Peace.